Jenny McCarthy Show.
Oh! Welcome back to the Jenny McCarthy Show. I'm Jenny McCarthy Wahlberg in studio with me right now. Boxing-inspired group fitness classes. Also, an amazing restaurant chain. It's going to be around the world soon. It already is around the world. It's in Dubai. It's opening in Las Vegas. It's called Catch. But his name is Eugene Remm. Hi, Eugene. How are you?
I'm feeling awesome. Thank you for having me.
What an intro with that song. I wanted to get up and fight right now.
Yes, but please don't fight me because you took Tai Bo and I'm not having
it. I know.
That.
I'm a badass Tai Boer.
Yes.
But that doesn't count. Rumble, this is so cool. You've got two things. I love entrepreneurs, and obviously you are a big one. Rumble, box-inspired group fitness classes. What is this?
What is this? Well, Rumble is a boxing-inspired group fitness class.
Why is it different?
It's different because it's the best, and it's different because it splits the class. So you spend half the time doing traditional boxing on this amazing water bag. So it's 180 pounds of water. So when you hit it,
nice.
You don't actually hurt your elbows, your wrists, your shoulder. So there's no impact. It's very low impact. And then the other half of the class is a full body workout. So honestly, when I grew up in New York, and I had this like massive like trainer boxer dude. He was an assassin security guard at one of my restaurants.
Nice.
And he got deported or whatever, something happened and he couldn't like be around anymore. So my option was either, $300 an hour trainer at like these like bougie places,
right.
or like $20 a month at like a jail gym.
Right.
And there was really nothing in the middle, and I'm a little too bougie for like the jail gym, and I still like group. And that's, my background obviously was nightclubs for a decade and restaurants right now. And I said, all right, I got these same people who drink with us and party with us, and now they're like getting a little older and getting up a little older, and all of a sudden everyone's like talking about their like kale and fiber intake, and like they still want that like hype.
Yeah.
But they want it in their fitness. So,
oh my God, you're speaking my language.
That's right. This is for you.
Holy, speaking my language.
And it's still a beautifully dark room. The place is luxurious. It's got really high-end finishes, but then you walk in, lights get low, blasting hip-hop and house music.
Oh my God.
And you go off for about 45 to 50 minutes, and you get out, you look like 10 buckets of water hit your head, you feel like you just beat the crap out of everyone that annoyed you for the last 24 hours, and then you go to work or go live your life.
I love that. And does it have, did you create the technology, or are you just smart enough to find it?
I'm not smart at all, but I have a really wonderful partner. So my partners, Andy Stensler, Anthony, and Noah, we kind of came up with this concept. So the water bag existed, and regular group fitness, fit concepts, boot camps existed.
Exactly.
But no one put them together. And the problem I find, I have this problem with chefs and I have this problem with trainers. Sorry, Joe, but trainers think everybody can lift 9,000 pounds and do 5,000 burpees. Chefs think everybody wants to eat like infused frog raw with like some this and that, but they don't know how to cook for normal people, and trainers don't know how to train for normal people.
That's so true.
I am neither a chef or a trainer, but I am an amazing customer. So from my end, I always thought that, hey, someone's got to understand this. So
yes.
This boxing class, so look, I consider boxing like hip-hop, right? Hip-hop is this super tough, swaggy thing that came from the streets, right? But then now it lives in like the suburbs where like you roll around in your like dad's car and you blast like music
yes.
about like has nothing to do with
no.
your life whatsoever. You're not tough. You're
no.
just blasting like angry music.
Exactly.
So, and hip-hop is my soul, and music is my soul. So I find boxing very similar to hip hop, where it's this thing that comes from the streets, things that come from like the bottom, but then like people want to put on these gloves and be like, I box.
Right.
Right.
So, even, I mean, for girls, it's very empowering too.
So when I tell my guy friends, hey, come to this, they're like, oh, I don't want to go to like spin class. I've been there before, like too many girls, too woo woo-y, not tough enough. Then they go to this and they get to be the tough part, but then they see lots of pretty girls.
Yeah,
so
it's a win-win.
It's a win-win. So it's whatever you want to be. If you want to be in your own world, punch something and walk out, it's there for you. If you want to be part of the whole class, meet everybody, pump fists and do the whole thing, you can do that too.
Why do you think guys aren't into group as much as girls are?
Because we're cavemen.
Is that
right? I really think because we're still like going into the gym to do like buys day
and you're just stretching. I mean, what is it called? Posing in the gym.
Yeah, I don't know if there's that much posing. What I really think it is that anything new is intimidating for men. I think women are much more inclined to try something different and fun, and they're more excited to say like, put four girlfriends together and say, do it. Now, when you even say the word group fitness, I still think 80% of New Yorkers wouldn't know what that is. So, you know, the leader in the industry 12 years around SoulCycle, right? Everyone, if you say group fitness, not sure, then you say SoulCycle, like, oh, yeah, I've been to that, or my friend goes to that. So they kind of created this industry, and they are the best within the spinning world. And then, you know, for us, we were like, all right, well, this doesn't exist in boxing, and spinning is very specific. Something's got to be a 360 body workout.
Thank God, because you know what? The spinning, I felt like it was just made my quads like Mary Lou Retton. You know, they were huge, giant quads, and it wasn't really working at my upper half.
Look, they're different strokes for different folks. I think different things work for different people. I can tell you this. HIIT training is works. Boxing works. Lifting weight works. We have all of it within 45 minutes. And the most important part of it, fun. It's this word that people forget in fitness, that you actually have to have fun, because it's brutal otherwise.
Brutal.
Other than the 10% who are like masochists, I think the rest of the world really like needs to have some entertainment. And I want to find entertainment in everything I do.
Do you get to punch other people?
No.
Can I sign up and request to punch like an employee I work with?
You can punch an employee you work with. You can also punch any of our trainers. They actually, after the class, they stand there and say, anyone willing to get punched, they're down.
You have one trainer here.
Yes. Joe Ferrara is with us. This
Hi,
young
Joe,
man right
what's
here.
What's up, man?
I'm good. Living.
Joe is a little uncomfortable right now because he usually has his shirt off in any public environment because that's how he gets his likes up. But today he's shirted because we're in a grown-up environment.
Why is it good for girls to box? Why is it a good workout?
Why is it a good workout?
Yeah. I think.
Come here, Joe. Tell the world.
Come on over.
Come here. Get the professional over here.
Why should we take up boxing?
Well, first of all, we all live in New York City, right? So I think everybody should know some sort of self-defense.
Well, we live
right?
in New York City, but this whole
Well, the whole
show,
world.
The whole
anybody.
Show.
Anywhere you are, you should. I just think, like you said, it's an empowering thing. I think it's something that for a long time, girls and even guys alike, for me, when I was a kid, I wanted to go to a boxing gym, but it's intimidating to step into a place where all these guys or these OGs have been doing it forever.
Right.
But here, I think we're opening up people's eyes that it's not a scary thing. You can come here, you can utilize the sport of boxing to get a great workout. You don't have to run on a treadmill. I hate to run.
Me too.
I always did. That's why I started boxing. And I think now people are like, oh crap, I can do this and it's fun and I can then go to another gym if I want to, some of these boxing gyms, to really, really learn the skill or train with a trainer at Rumble. And I think it's an empowering thing to learn, empowering skill to have.
Is there weightlifting in half the class?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Half
nice.
The class. And it's interesting because some other places they'll be like, yo, go grab the 40s. I'm like, grab the 40s, dude. I'm like, you know, I can't even grab the 20s. So
right.
What we really focus is we give you an array of weight. So you can go from anything to a 5 pound to an 85 pound if you're like a real, real gorilla. So like there's really a range, and I can be doing 50s, you can be doing fives, and we're both going to feel good, and that's really the strategy behind it. So it's for everyone. It's trying to remove the like, oh, you got to be tough to do this, or oh, you have to be in great shape. What
right.
about the people who are like, the whole point is people aspiring to be in great shape.
Correct.
You don't be giving them in great shape. You got to earn it.
Totally.
So it's like, where do you start?
Is this something that's going to be eventually in across the country?
Well, it is across the country. So right now we have leases signed in Los Angeles, Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, and San Francisco. So those are going to be opening in the next 6 months. We also have a double studio opening up on the Upper East Side. So we are on a massive, aggressive growth strategy right now, and we're moving. We can't open them fast enough. So right now—
How about St. Charles, Illinois?
That's
yeah.
the next one.
Joe's going to oversee. Yeah, I don't even know where Illinois is, but I think it's a wonderful place with wonderful people.
It is. There's a lot of MILFs there.
Are there?
Tons that we just want to work out. I mean, there's MILFs everywhere, but especially in this neighborhood. I'm looking online at something. What am I looking at?
That's me. Look at that.
Come on.
That's Joe.
That's one of our trainers, Christina Jensen, hanging from my arm. Right there.
Jesus photo shoot that we Christ.
Did. So another interesting thing that we do is we spend a lot of our efforts on digital strategy. So we spend a lot of time on Instagram and social media.
Smart.
And it's really kind of exploded our entire brand. And we really focus a lot of our brand growth on social. And what I've realized is that people want to promote themselves doing fit things, right? So it's not like back in the day, I used to like throw like 5 bottles at a nightclub, put them in the thing, and be like, "Look, I bought 5 bottles."
Yeah.
I really think you're really like an ass if you're doing
right.
that today.
So people like to take pictures of their healthy salads
right.
and shit like that,
and then they don't take the picture of their like crappy sandwich on their desk the next day,
right, but they're
just really going to do that.
Or the hangover Big Mac.
That's right.
Let's name drop. Who are some of the big names that have come in the class to try out?
I can tell you that, you know, Kevin Hart has been there. I can tell you that David Beckham has been there. I can tell you that Justin Bieber has been there. I can tell you that Selena Gomez has been there. These are some people that have take the class. They just come in like a normal person. They come do the thing. They punch the thing. And they go on with their lives.
So they're not buying out the place. They're actually with the people.
We have never... Kevin Hart took out the space and he did four classes in a row that he did for a charity. And he did... I don't remember. It was like...
Move with Heart.
Move with Heart. And that was an amazing thing that he did, where he came in from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. and did four classes in a row for charity for him and his group. So that was a really special occasion. But other than that, people are like, oh, I don't like to work out in group environments. And I'll be like, well, do you like to eat at restaurants? I was like, you're not eating with the 300 other people that you're there. You're just eating with the person you're with. So you're punching with that bag. If you choose to interact with the other tables, you can. But for the most part, if you want it, it's as simple as you do. But I can tell you this. The lights go down. People, everyone's like, oh, what are people going to think of me? And then you take the class and you realize, I'm not looking
not
at
looking
anyone.
At
I'm just trying to, like, live. I'm just trying to survive. And I'm just trying to have fun here. And you get really lost in yourself. So look, people need a version of therapy. And therapy is an important part of our lives right now. So there's the kind where you sit and meditate and quiet, and there's the type where you're active. And I can tell you, from the moment that class starts to the moment that class finishes, I am not thinking about my emails. I'm not thinking about my businesses. I'm just thinking about punching this bag, lifting these weights. I check myself out in the mirror, and then I move on.
So it allows you to be in the present moment, which a lot of us are incapable of doing because we're so busy.
Or just because we're incapable. And I think whether we're busy or not, it's something that all of us need to work on. And we need to work on it from the mental side, and we need to work on it from the physical side. And if you don't have both, it's a wrap. Like, you have to be great at everything now to make it through this
That's
world.
That's true. I'm talking to Eugene Remm. What he's promoting is Rumble Boxing, and it's going to be obviously everywhere across the country soon. Can people take this out as a franchise, or is it you guys owning it?
We are owning everything right now. We want to control the brand. We want to control the message. We want to control the trainers. We want to control the quality, quite honestly. So right now, we have the bandwidth to open up in all of these different cities, and we feel really great about our ability to do so. Obviously, also, with my background, doing New York, doing LA, doing Dubai, doing Mexico, we have the scale and we know how to do this. This isn't my first rodeo. Andy Stanzer, my partner, has probably opened 500 cozy sandwich restaurants and like 100 Kidsville locations. So scale is something that we're good at. So it's usually find someone who's either good at one thing. You're either people who are dope at brand and the creative, and then they just absolutely fall on their face when it comes to operations, or you get those really great operators but have absolutely no character or swag whatsoever to reach the young audience. And you're starting to see that in big companies like Coke and Pepsi, where they basically can't create a cool product to save their lives.
No.
So what they're doing is buying cool products and then bringing it into them. And what they realize is, like, if you let them live on their own, they can be successful. If you bring them into these big, big, big organizations, they suffocate. And I think what we do really interesting is we still have that entrepreneur one by one kind of like get up and grind thing, but we have a ton of structure and systems in place for growth. And that's really where you can be a threat in any business. And because of obviously the background in the restaurants and catch and what we're doing there, this just felt like an obvious segue to it. So it kind of worked both ways.
Speaking of catch, let's talk about that now.
Yes.
It's a restaurant that you own, and there's what, in New York, Los Angeles, Dubai, Mexico, coming out in Las Vegas in what, May?
November.
What kind of restaurant is this? What do you serve?
So Catch is a company I started with Mark Birnbaum, my partner for 15 years. Tillman Fertitta, who owns Landry's, the Houston Rockets, and on Billion Dollar Buyer, just acquired half of our company. So that happened in June of last year.
Congratulations!
Thank you. Yes, I have a big man behind me now to help us grow.
Awesome.
Yes,
yeah.
he is fabulous. And what it is, it's a 400 seat Asian infused seafood restaurant, and it's a little bit of everything. It's sushi, it's steak, it's seafood, it's shareable, it's great, and it's one in New York, one in LA. Those are the two big flagships for the brand. New York opened in 2011, I believe, in September of 2011, and that's we're going into our eighth year, and it's unheard of that a place in New York stays this hot or this Correct. Relevant actually for 8 years, and that's what the growth of it.
All I know is that people have around me talk about this place constantly.
It's interesting, and it's four restaurants in one. There's like the 5:30 to 7, which is more your traditional dining. Your 7 and 9:30, which is more the powerhouse, and then you have this late night boom of the people who are choosing not to necessarily go to the traditional nightclubs, but want to go out, want to have a late night bite and have a drink and still
Genius.
Listen to like great music. You know, 8 years ago, they said, you know, don't be loud at late in the evening. It's a proper restaurant, and you know, don't play hip hop and don't play loud music. It was very anti.
Wow.
And
you found a need big time.
You know, it's interesting. Mark and I say this a lot. You know, we are our demographic.
Yeah.
And my biggest thing is, you know, Andy Stenzer, my partner in Rumble, he's big on data and he looks for structure and he likes to find where the data goes. And I just say, I don't want to even know data. Just
right.
go by gut. If I like it, I think other people like it. One day when I don't like it, and when I like it and no one else does, then I'll start working with data and start doing other
exactly.
things.
Exactly. But right now you have a perfect partnership.
That's right. And in a restaurant, it's impossible to really use data because you walk in a room and you kind of like look around and be like, I think there's a 50-50 mix of men and women. Everyone looks at their, you know,
right.
averaging $100,000 to $150,000 a year of income. You don't have that information in a restaurant, which is why it becomes one of the hardest businesses in the world.
Truly. Like, but you're killing it.
We're working hard, and we found a product. And by the way, we haven't always killed it. There have been things we've done that haven't done great. And I think it's important to tell people out there when they're talking about to entrepreneurs that we made a lot of mistakes along the way. And, you know, I watched the fight on Saturday night, right? And I watched what was the guy's name? Walker? What was his name?
Deontay Wilder.
Wilder, yes. Wilder fought the whole fight, hit him hard, and all of a sudden saw that the guy was wobbly, and then his eyes lit up, and then he went in for it. And I think that's very much how an entrepreneur goes. Like, you fight, you're not sure what's happening, then you see a moment where you see something that actually
100%.
Works, and then you're like, oh boy, we're going after it. So we own nightclubs for about a decade. And we started good ones, and we started some that weren't so great. And then we saw this catch thing. It's like, hey, all this other stuff takes a lot of work, but this catch thing is just great, and people want it.
I always find it's like, if I'm looking for something that I actually want or a need that's not out there. I just created a vodka cocktail that's gluten-free and has made with electrolytes that's not out there, so you don't get hungover.
You can have it right after a Rumble class,
that's
and then
right.
you'll be good to go.
But it was the exact same thing of like, I have a need that
that's
I want
right.
filled, and it just so happens that I just don't want to have to make it anymore, so just mass make it, and everyone else can enjoy it also.
If I could say anything to young entrepreneurs or people who are listening to this, find that.
Yeah.
Find that thing that you think, A, you need, and that you think other people will need, and see if there's an opportunity to make a business of it. Because if you love it, and you actually have a passion for it.
Exactly.
Like, I love the food at Catch. It is my favorite cuisine. I would go eat at Catch 7 days a week, and people are like, oh, let's go to dinner. Like, let's go somewhere else, because I know you must be tired of it. The answer is, I'm not.
No, exactly.
I'm really not at all. And, you know, I consider sushi and boxing very similar. It's a weird analogy, but I want to give it to you. Sushi is something that's hundreds of years old. It came in and started like a boring little restaurant with wood floor. Nobody talked. You just came in. You had this basic roll. You ate it. You loved
right.
it. You moved on. Boxing, same thing. You walked in, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, do the rounds. With sushi, then Nobu came out, and all of a sudden you got all these sauces
right.
and all these creative things, and all of a sudden you got a little bit of like a house beat behind it, and next thing you know, it's this thing, and it takes a life of its own. It becomes America's cuisine more than it is even
True.
Asian cuisine. It is a very strong cuisine in the United States. I would say it's probably bigger than Italian. I think it's bigger than Mexican.
I agree.
And the same with boxing. Boxing is a old school sport that was done a very specific way. And you know, even Joe would tell you, like, we meet with other trainers, they'll be like, that's not the way you do it. Well, it's not the way you do it because it's just boring the
oh,
way you've
see,
done it.
I love that. So breaking outside the mold is everything.
Yeah, just because you have to sit at the kitchen table and eat from left to right and this to that, like, why?
Right.
I think anytime you have an opportunity to challenge something that's traditional and make it new, that's where you really win. And I can tell you the only consistency in this world moving forward is change. So anything that's been done the way it was done, say, do it again that way. Wrong. Have to do it differently.
You're right. I'm your audience completely.
Good.
I cannot wait. I'm going to join the gym, too, if that's okay.
You don't have to join. You just have to come and punch something.
Oh, my God. I can't wait. You brought boxing gloves for me, didn't you?
We're going to show you the quick six punches if you
All
got
right.
a second.
We're going to do that as a commercial break as we go out. Boxing-inspired group fitness classes, Rumble. You guys can go to rumble-boxing.com and also check out Catch in New York, L.A., Dubai, Mexico, and in November, Las Vegas. Eugene Remm, what a pleasure.
Thank you.
To be continued on this relationship. I'm going to box on the way out.
There you go.
All right, bring it. Fitting is a frustration.
Jenny McCarthy Show. Oh!